Stay quiet. Aye. Sorry, 我没有讲到。OK. Thank you. -5 -1 + λ (2 - 2, 1). This is from last week. Boleh, huh? Okay, then after that, I want to find a formula n from the origin to line 1. This is my line 1. This is my line 1. This is the cube origin. Okay, I want to find the foot of the perpendicular from the origin to line 1. I want to find the position vector of the foot of the perpendicular. It's exactly what you all did in the test. So, L1 is -8, (5, -1) + λ (2, -2, 1). Okay, where lambda is real. Let's say I call this n. Okay, this is O. What is my next step? I want to find this point. Okay, I want to find this point. What's my next step? Since, okay, Hui Xing don't say, okay, Megan? No, Carl? Claire? Since what? Since what was the next step to find the position? Find N. I want to find N. Fantastic. Since n lies on the line. Since, okay, must remember we are talking about the point n, not the position vector on. Point n lies on the line, but the position vector doesn't lie on the line. Since n lies on L1, so on can be expressed as yes. Very good. For some lambda, okay? So from this, right, we know that ON, because it lies on line 1, right, it can be expressed in the form of that line 1, okay? For some lambda, it is true. After we find ON, my next step is to find? So let me ask you, this ON here, is it a position vector? Is it a direction vector? In this case, it is also a direction vector because it's O lah, huh? So very quickly, my next step is I can say ON dot product with the direction vector of line 1 should be equals to 0. Okay, so I just take, oh yay, do this. Okay, then after that, oh, -8 + 2λ (5 - 2λ) - (1 + λ). This is a very predictable kind of question. Ask you find four. The position vector straight, or you know, the step just come out of your head, equals to 0. Okay, so solve this to get your lambda. Lambda equals to 3. Very good. ON equals to
-2, -1, 2.
Very good. They were actually asking for the position vector. So because the question asked for position vector. Oh no, coordinates is a point. So if I ask you to, okay, I ask you to state a point, right? Then you write A, B, C. This is a point. But if I want you to state a vector, right? Then you write A, B, C. This is a position. This is a position vector. Okay, huh? I'll give you an example. If I just talk about the two-dimensional sense, okay, like that, right? This is the x-axis, this is the y-axis. 2, 3. The point, right? Cartesian, right? But if I give you this, if I draw you this, this is the vector 2, 3, right? Okay? So vector got at direction. How? Yeah. You yawn so loud, I can put Mr. Shum's hand into your mouth. Okay? So after that, we are done, right? So all can get ON. ON is equals to -2, -1, +2. Okay? Yes. Oh. Just line up, step count. Okay, then after that, next one. Part 3. Okay, part 3, we want to find the point of intersection of line 1 and line 2. Okay, is it difficult?
No.
There's a similar template example in your notes. So all you need to do is you put them together and you solve simultaneously. Find the point of intersection of line 1 and line 2. Of line 1 and line 2. Yes, for me. In this case, let me see. It's possible. It's possible. It's possible. Very good. But there's some extra step. I need to substitute into the third equation. Okay. Something like that. Very good. Okay. So here, right? Line one, right? In line one, right? We can say that your x, y, z, right, are of this form. In line one, the x, y, z are of this form. Okay, in my line 2, what does my x, y, z look like? In line 2, what does my x, y, z look like? Since, okay, so from here x, y, z is equals to 6 alpha, alpha. Okay, no, doesn't matter. Okay, so can we say this?
Yes.
Can, right? What do we do?
Okay, when
you see an R, don't be funny. You remember I told you every time x, y, z is the connecting variable, x, y, z connects, x, y, z connects. That's why parametric form is the easiest to do calculation. From here, right, you just equate negative 8 plus 2 lambda at the point of intersection. Okay, negative 8 plus 2 lambda should be equals to 6 alpha. Okay. Okay, negative 1 plus lambda should be equals to alpha. You have equation 1, equation 2, equation 3. Just take any two and solve. Okay, so maybe if I take the first two and solve, what will my lambda, what will my alpha and lambda be? Very good. So in this case, right, then after that, find the vector equation of the reflection of line 2 in the line 1. Find the vector equation of the reflection of line 2 in the line 1. Okay, so this one relatively quite interesting. So I have line 2. Let's say I call this line 2. I call this line 1. Okay, what's this point? Later I'll ask. Okay, so let's say maybe this is the, you agree with me? Let's say if I use this as the line one is a reflection, right? Line, so this becomes something like that. The red color portion is so called my line 2. Agree?
Yes.
Then, okay. So right. If you look at line two, right? Okay. One interesting thing about line two is. This particular point we have, right? This particular point is okay. So how do I know this from part 3? Okay, so this is your point P, and here I put it P here. So moral of the story is all your tutorials, like every question should have a diagram. Always start your question with a diagram. Okay, when you got a diagram, then you have a better picture how to do. Because I can tell you a lot of times you must cannot visualize one. Okay? So every silly question vectors are not vectors, draw a diagram first. Okay? Draw a diagram first. Okay, Desiree? Draw a diagram first. Okay? So this is the point of the section. Okay, what else do I know? The origin online is online too. Okay, the origin is on line 2. Fantastic. Why? Because if we look at this equation of line 2, can you see? Line 2, I can also say it's the same as 0, 0, 0. Okay, you have to know this, huh? Okay, guys, you see, if I put like that, it straight away tells you the origin is on line, it's on the line. Okay, here, right, straight away you can tell the origin is on the line. Okay, I sidetrack a bit. 0, 0, 0, maybe let me just put it here. Maybe 0, 0, 0 lies on line 2. Okay, so from line 2, what else do I know? Can go down to n on line 1. So I look at this. What is this point on line 1? This point. Okay, minus 2, minus 1, 2. How do I know? I go back to the question. Find the position vector of the 4 perpendicular n from the origin to line 1. From the origin to line 1. So there are a few tricky things here. Number 1, right? We have to determine that the origin lies on line 2. Number 2, okay, that's to connect the line 2, origin to line 1. This is, as we found earlier in part 2, the point of intersection ON, you see this is N, right? Equals to negative 2, negative 1, 2. Okay, so let's say if I call this maybe N prime. Okay, let's say this is N, right? N is a 4 perpendicular. And I call this N prime. What will the position vector of N prime be? This case, because the origin is here. So, can you use the theorem? A bit hard, right? Can I tell ma? Anyone don't understand? Zhou Lan? Megan? Siyun? Yen? Yen ignore me. Yen Paul, 不理我. Okay. This is ON, right? So you look, this is ON. N of N prime. By right, ON should be equal to N of N prime, right? Because they are reflection. Yeah. Correct. Okay. So actually they are the same. Okay, so if this is negative 2, negative 1, so actually, right, ON prime should be equal to 2 times of ON. Is it okay?
Yes.
Very hard. Because in this case, the only way to do this question, or guys, is to draw the diagram. You don't draw a diagram, you cannot see. You sure cannot solve one. Okay? So ON prime actually is just equals to negative 4, negative 2, 4. Okay? So this is just a negative 4, negative 2, 4. Okay, ma? When you see reflection, every time you can think about ratio theorem. But also sometimes, there's no need to use ratio theorem. In this case, it's very straightforward. Oh, so fast. Oh, so fast. Time flies when I'm having fun. Okay. Okay, yeah, long. So this is the N prime. So now this boils down to this question. Okay, focus on what I put down in purple. Okay, maybe should I put purple?
Yes.
Okay, or pink, green. Pink. Okay, this pink. Now let's look at this red color line. I have 2 points. Can I find this equation of this line?
Yes.
Yes, right. So very easy. I find the direction vector. So let's say direction vector. Maybe I call this Q N prime, right? So Q N prime is just equals to maybe I call it N prime Q, okay? Negative 9, 6, negative 3 over 2, subtract negative 4, negative 2, 4. This will give me the direction vector, which is half of negative 10, 16, negative 11. Okay? So I get the direction vector. What else do I do? Now I put in the equation of the line. Okay, I go to the next page. Ready? Next page. Okay, so given that your direction vector is negative 10, 16, negative 11, the equation of the line is just equal to, I take the point P for position vector with let me just use a mu negative 10, 16, negative 11, where mu is real. Okay, that's the equation of the reflection. Okay, give me 1 minute, I quickly run through the big picture again. Okay, how we did the reflection, this was line 2, this was line 1. Okay, before that, we know that line 2 contains the origin from our own understanding. We have to draw the diagram. We also know that we have this point N, right? We have the point of intersection, which is P. Alright, so what we do is we use this to help us. And then we draw, we found that this is M prime. M prime, O M prime is just equals to 2 times of O N. Okay, we get a position vector of O M prime. We have O P, we have O M prime. We can find the vector. Okay, Claire, Carl, you're dating or what? Don't stop, it's recording. I'm going to show your parents, Carl. I'm going to show your parents too, Claire. Okay, Claire and Carl are dating. Okay, they are talking during my class in a very intimate manner.